here on BBC Radio Shropshire, the Sports Hour, until 7 o'clock with me, Mary-Kate Wheeldon. Now we're going to talk about a sport which I will admit I didn't know a lot about before I had a fantastic conversation with Mark Jones. But it's all about pickleball. It's one of the fastest growing sports in the world. Over 4.2 million people in America have taken on the sport, and that bug has crossed the pond to Shropshire with demand ever growing. And Mark Jones set up Oswestry Pickleball Club in just April and already has 3 sold out groups a week. And he told me all about it.
If you think about it as a combination, most people describe it as a combination between table tennis, lawn tennis, if you like, and badminton. But the badminton element is only because it's played on a badminton court. So imagine a badminton court. They got a tennis kind of net, which is held a little bit lower than a tennis net. And you basically play with a paddle. And so basically there's nothing else you need to play the game as such, you know. It's mainly played, I would say, as a doubles game, although it can be played in singles. It's now in the States become a professional game, and it's really going places. And it's, as I say, it's the world's fastest growing sport. So the beauty of it, I suppose, is that you can learn it in literally one session. I can give instruction for, I don't know, 20 minutes or something, and you can be up and running and playing, you know, and you can learn it that quickly and that easy. So it's similar to all those other games that I've mentioned, but different.
So how did you get into it?
So it's a bit weird. I mean, give us the background. I'm a failed badminton player. So, I mean, you could call it a proper wacky, weird, and yet wonderful sport now, in a sense of, until I found it, you know, I couldn't have been more wrong. So basically my daughter, who lives in Grand Caymans, and there's a large American contingent of people in America, in Cayman, sorry, they play a heck of a lot of pickleball. So when we went out there this year to visit my daughter, that was pickleball frenzy. Literally everybody we spoke to was playing. So I got the chance, and the date will go down in history, I guess, 24th of February, 2024, I got my chance to play my first game, which I played along with my brother and with my son-in-law. We played along with his friend and his father. Basically, I was completely pummeled. I was useless at it. Literally, the moment I came off the court, I wanted to play again because I was convinced I could be better than that. You know, me and Julia, my wife, have been completely hooked ever since, you know, and it's a fabulous game.
Yeah, it sounds like you've really fallen in love with it. Tell me what you're doing now then for other people to get into the sport.
Yeah, so as I say, in the UK, you know, we're looking at 21,000 and growing fast. We came home in mid-March and we thought to ourselves, we've got to just start playing this year and share it amongst friends, family, everybody we knew, because it was such an amazing game. And it's difficult to describe to anybody until you've played it. And trust me, when played it once, nobody plays once, everybody plays again. So we decided we could get a game in Shrewsbury, but it's a bit of a travel to get up there and so on, you know. Given the fact that Julia and I were regular gym goers in the Oswestry Leisure Centre, we saw the courts pretty much empty most days. So we thought, you know what? What the heck? Let's just have a go ourselves. So basically, I put myself through the Pickleball England Leadership course, which is fantastic. Thoroughly enjoyed that, along with 15 other people from around the country and so on. We went ahead, bought all the equipment. We bought nets and paddles and balls, etc., etc. We began some marketing. We created a flyer. We got a website. We got a Facebook page. And we approached the Oswestry Leisure Centre, and they've been exceptionally good with us and very cooperative in helping us get this thing off the ground. So a big shout out to Jack and Taylor from the Leisure Centre at Oswestry, who have been fantastic supporting us with this now. So from the beginning, Julia and I decided, look, we're not going to make money out of this. We don't want to make money out of this. It's not about that. We just want the pure pleasure of bringing such an amazing sport to all in the region and so on. So we said, look, how can we just about do it and just about cover our costs for hiring the courts and so on, and try to recover some money back from the investment that we'd made? But we wanted to keep it really cheap. So we've kept it, thank goodness. Thanks again to Oswestry Leisure Centre, at a £5 per person per session. We set it up officially on the 24th of April, and we now play 3 times per week. So and we've got a fantastic new announcement to make about a new, or let's call it an additional venue. Pleased to tell you that it's St. Martin's School. We negotiated a deal with them yesterday, so we now can officially say we have St. Martin's School from 7:30 till 9:30 every Thursday night from the 20th of July. And it's mainly due to huge demand for evening playing when people are at work during the day and all the rest of it, you know. Yeah, we're up and running and enjoying every minute and selling out on every session at the moment.
Yeah, it's crazy. You started this, you know, and you only started playing yourself in February, started the clubs in April. It's grown remarkably quick.
It's phenomenal. I mean, lots of people will say, look, I've heard of it. I'm intrigued. What is it, et cetera, et cetera. You know, there's lots of people who will just come along for a look. And trust me, we'll call them down from the balconies and say, well, come on, don't just stand there. Here's a paddle. Have a go. See what you think. And people just take to it. It's just one of those things. And it's, I can only describe it as literally like wildfire now. It's really gone off the scale for us, you know. So Julia and I are just over the moon. We're just so pleased because, you know, and I've never really been involved in anything like voluntary work or charity work. Julia's done a little bit with a nursing background and so on. But I just can't tell you how rewarding it is for both of us to be bringing along people and seeing smiles on faces when we've all had a pretty rough time, whether it's, you know, COVID or Brexit or the financial pinch, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. We all need something to smile about. We really do need something to lift our spirits about. And trust me, and pickleball's not the answer to it, but by God, it goes a long way, I would say.
Yeah, so this is, you know, this is what's happening now. The game has been growing really quickly already in just a few months, you know, in Oswestry for you, and it's growing all over the place. What kind of do you see the future of the sport being?
Yeah, for sure. The sport is going to grow exponentially. There's no doubt about that. For ourselves, we've now basically reached out to smaller clubs, stroke groups within the area. For example, we've buddied up with a group from Wrexham. We've buddied up with Ellesmere College where they play quite regularly. And we're going to be holding inter-group or club tournaments in the future. So that's going to be great fun. I think we've got our first one set out for July the 13th. But other things that we're thinking about is that we're really keen to introduce this to the younger members of our society. So we would be more than happy, again, on a volunteer basis, we don't want any money for it, to bring the game along to the youth and so on, of particularly in this case, St. Martin's School. We're pretty excited about the future. You know, we're talking about maybe more daytime sessions, more evening sessions, and basically nose to tail, Julia and I won't be getting much sleep for pickleball. So the future's good. Yeah, we're very excited about it.
Well, if you want to get involved in the sessions, they run every Sunday, Tuesday and Wednesday at Oswestry Leisure Centre. That's Mark Jones there trying to convince me to go down and have a game of pickleball. It does look like a lot of fun. And if you want to watch some videos, if you want to see what they're all about, then you can contact the group on Facebook. Just search for Oswestry Pickleball.